In this lesson, we're going to make our particle systems producer follow a path using a null object. Okay, so we're right here where we left off in our last lesson, and right now our particles are not moving, and we also learned in our last lesson that getting that position to change over time is possible, but you can't really make it follow a curve without setting keyframes almost every other frame. So let's go ahead and create a null object, and that I'm going to just show you how with this null object we can make this a lot simpler. So go up to Layer, New, Null Object, and it's fine that this isn't a 3D layer. We're just going to leave it 2D. Go ahead and grab this, and we'll move it up here so that that upper left-hand corner where you see the anchor point is right there on the edge or the tip of this little orange piece here. So that's orange 3. So go ahead now, and we'll open up the position property for this null by hitting the P key. And I'll go ahead and set a position just right there. And then let's move forward about 25, 26, or 27 frames, something like that. Just give it a decent amount of time. And then I'm going to move it all the way to the other end over that amount of time. And now you can see that we have this nice motion path. Now this just happens because of the nature of a null is going to give you that capability, whereas the producer in that particle system doesn't give us that option. So I'm going to go ahead and start pulling on these handles, and you can see that really quickly and really easily I'm able to get this nice curve that goes right through the middle of the shape. Now I'm going to turn off my particle system for a second and show you that it still isn't completely perfect. We have this right side over here looking pretty good, but we need just a little bit more of a curve in this edge. So I think we may need to add just one more keyframe. So I'm just going to kind of go in the middle here, just right about there probably. We'll set another key. And then let's just move our null object kind of up and over a little bit. And we can start to play with those handles a little bit better and just kind of move that along our path. Let's zoom in up here and kind of see what's going on. It is quite thin in this area. A little bit hard to tell if you're getting it just right. But I think that looks pretty good right there. If you need to manipulate the anchor points separately from each other, you can always go up to your pen tool, grab the Convert Vertex tool, and just click one of those handles and start moving it around, and it'll be able to be moved independently from the handle on the other side. Okay, so this looks great. I'm really happy with that. Now, I want to go ahead and just figure out what I want the motion for this to look like, because you'll notice that the dots on this motion path are a lot closer together here at the beginning than we have them at the end, and that's because this keyframe is so much earlier in time. So one of the things I want to pay attention to is here at the end, I don't want this just to slam into this end and have the particles end. I want them to kind of slow into this finish. So I'm going to go ahead, we'll select that keyframe and add Easy Ease to it. So go up to Animation, choose Keyframe Assistant Easy Ease. And that's going to put these a little bit closer together just right there at the end. And if you want to, you can even go into the graph editor and start to pull out this handle and give it some influence, and just right in there, about 82% influence, that's going to put those dots even closer together and make it even slower into that final keyframe. Okay, so now you'll notice we're getting even more of a discrepancy in our speed for our null. So it's going to go really slow here at the beginning, then speed up really quickly once it hits this keyframe, and then slow in again. So an easy way to fix that is just to select all of the keys, right click, and choose Rove Across Time. And what that does is it takes this keyframe and it figures out how much space we need in between the first and the last key, and in between those little dots, and makes it even. So now we have a nice linear kind of just ease out of that, or not really ease, it's just going at the same speed from the start and then slows into the end. So we don't get that weird jump in speed now for the null. And if I just did a RAM preview like I did there, you can't really see it because a null object is invisible, and that's why they're great for using in this way, where you basically have the control to animate an invisible shape and then tell things to follow it around. So that's what we're going to do next. I'm going to go ahead and we'll turn back on our particle system, and let's go just select that particle system so that we can see up here in our project panel. And what I want to do is parent this particle system to this null so it follows along with it. But if I just simply grab the parent pick whip that we see out here and drag it onto the null, it's not going to work really, because the particles need to be able to look at the whole shape here so that if particles need to go off screen, they have that ability. So let me just show you what I mean. If I just grab this parenting pick whip and drag it onto my null, you can see the whole thing is going to move, and down here now the particles don't go off screen anymore. So that's not really what you want. I'm going to undo that, and what we actually need to do is use our expression pick whip, and that's going to allow us to parent more specific things. So we're going to want to parent the specific position of that emitter that we've created, or the producer position, to the position of the null. So that gives us a lot more specific data. So all we have to do is have both of those positions open here, and I'm going to alt click on the position of the particles. So hold down alt and click that position stopwatch. Then grab your expression pick whip and drag it to the position of the null. Then you can just click off, and now you can see that those particles are much, much better following that arc that we've created. So this is looking pretty good, but right now those particles are still falling off of this top part of my curve, and I want them to stay up there. So what I need to do is just adjust a few parameters, and the easiest thing to adjust is going to be the resistance. So let's go back over here to our physics. I'm going to turn that resistance up, and we'll just pull this handle all the way up to about 200 there. That's as high as it can go, and we can also just go ahead and turn up the radius for some of these properties. So for our X radius, let's turn that up to, let's just do 8. That seems pretty good. And then for this one, for the Y radius, let's do 9. And so now we can scrub through here, and you can see those particles are basically going to fill in across the shape and then cover the whole thing up. And then we have just a couple frames here at the end where the whole shape is covered up by that particle system we've created. So this is looking really good. I'm really happy with these results. We've got our null in place, which is controlling the emitter position, and then we have our particle system. So now all that's left is to take both of these layers, and we'll drop them right there on top of the orange piece that we're working with here. So what I want to do is now create my mat. So let's just come over here and choose alpha mat for the orange. And still the particle system is what's acting as what we used as our ink earlier. So now if I scrub through here as that alpha mat, now we have basically shown everything around those particles, and we could just get this really nice effect of those particles wiping on across that shape, and you can see how they follow that null really, really perfectly. So I wanted just to start out kind of easy here with you being able to learn how to do that null, parent the position, and now in between lessons, I'm going to go ahead and repeat this process for our other three orange layers. And I encourage you, just as we did in our whenever we were revealing the water part of our logo, you know, try to stagger that timing a little bit, you know, make it more interesting. Maybe one of these comes on, you know, this one we could have come on first, and then we have our other two layers come on a little bit later than that. So really, really just keep it more interesting. I think if everything reveals on at the same time, it's definitely just a little more static. So in this lesson, we learned how to make that particle system follow along a specific path as created by a null. And then also we use that particle system as an alpha mat to reveal our shape. So come back in our next lesson, and we're going to learn how to create some interest with using appropriate textures for our logo. So I want the logo, after everything has been revealed, since that's what we're kind of finishing up in this lesson, to have some textures that kind of continue to animate on top of it as the logo continues to transform over the rest of that 10-second duration that we're working with here.